Monster and Chips, Food Fright by David O'Connell, read by Oliver J. Hembrough. Prologue. Did you know that there are places where our ordinary world rubs against strange, magical worlds? When this happens, holes sometimes get worn between the two, creating doorways. It can happen anywhere. Perhaps on a street near you. An ordinary-looking door will appear, so ordinary that you might not even notice it. Like the door of a diner. Just a place that sells burgers and chips. But there might be a very special diner on the other side of that door, with very special customers. Chapter 1. Terror of the Towering Sandwiches. Joe Shu was bored. It was quite possibly the longest school day of his entire life. His teacher, Mrs. Spratley, was going for the world record on how many dull subjects can you talk about without taking a breath. It was looking like she had a good chance of beating the previous record holder, also Mrs. Spratley, by some way. Her current subject was sock making in the Himalayas. To relieve the boredom, school bully Grotty Grace was casually flicking the back of Joe's head with a rubber band.
I'm just softening your head up for the thumping you'll get later, you little bum toot, she growled over Joe's shoulder.
Joe didn't bother to argue. It would be like trying to reason with a snappish grump monster. And Joe had met enough of those to know better. Joe had met a lot of strange creatures at Fuzzby's Diner. Fuzzby's was a cafe for hungry monsters, and it served the best chips anywhere. Joe had discovered the monster diner hidden down a spooky alley behind a magic door. It was owned by Fuzzby Bixington, a big green friendly monster who had offered Joe a job. Joe helped to serve the monster customers and cook the disgusting food they loved to eat. He was the only Who Man, as they called him, who had ever found the diner, and he'd been having loads of adventures with Fuzzby and his monster friends ever since.
Brrrring!
Much to Joe's relief, the school bell rang. He quickly dodged Grace's fat hands as she tried to grab him and rushed out of the school gates. I bet Fuzzby never got the back of his head flicked by a rubber band, thought Joe, as he ran down the alley to the familiar red door of Fuzzby's diner with its bright neon sign. But when the door opened, it wasn't Fuzzby who greeted him, but a large, furry yellow monster with one big eye and a pair of horns.
Hello, Joe,
it said cheerily, just like Fuzzby normally did. Was Fuzzby wearing a costume, dressing up as another monster? Joe was confused until a green furry face appeared over the other monster's shoulder, grinning happily. It was the real Fuzzby, in his striped apron, waving a spatula dripping with bubbling brown grease.
Hello, Joe, he said. I see you've met my cousin, Zuffby. He's here for a visit.
The diner wasn't too busy, so Joe and Zuffby sat down at one of the tables while Fuzzby continued cooking. They sat next to the Guzzlins, a family of little rock monsters who were regulars at Fuzzby's. The Guzzlins were slurping their favourite Pongleberry and Gurglefish milkshake and giggling whenever little Lemmy Guzzlin burped purple bubbles from drinking too quickly.
I've heard all about you, Joe, said Zuffby,
with the same cheery grin as his cousin.
Fuzzby tells me you're the key ingredient for the smooth running of the diner.
After me, of course, came a gruff voice.
A four-eyed creature with tentacles slithered onto the chair next to Joe. It was Barry, the diner's cat. He didn't look like a cat, but no one was going to argue with Barry, as he liked arguing and he was very good at it.
I taught Joe everything he knows, Barry said importantly,
and gave Joe a look that dared him to say otherwise.
Maybe you can teach Fuzzby a thing or two about cooking, said Zuffby with a wink.
or possibly a blink. It was difficult to tell when a monster only had one eye. Fuzzby pretended to look cross for a second. Then they both roared with laughter. Joe glanced up at the day's specials displayed on a board on the wall. Today's specials. Caterpillar jelly and chips. Greasy blotch burger and chips. Sausage hairball and chips. Cheese on toes and chips. Fungus fritters and chips. Octopus eggs and chips. Joe didn't think that Fuzzby needed any lessons on how to cook, especially if you like to eat things that came out of jars labelled revolting, extra hairy, and possibly poisonous. Do you cook as well? Asked Joe.
We're all cooks in the Bixington family, explained Fuzzby. Zuffby runs a sandwich shop in Monster World.
Zuffby's Mega Monster Sandwich Emporium, to be precise, the big yellow monster said proudly.
There's nothing that goes on between two slices of bread that I don't know about, though my favourite sandwich is the BLT.
Bacon, lettuce and tomato, said Joe, surprised. Monsters didn't normally go in for Who-Man food.
No, bog slime, lice and toad wart, said Zuffby, with the crusts cut off to make them nice and posh. I'm also quite partial to sneeze and pickle, spawn mayonnaise and peanut butter and jelly. I know all the special sandwich fillings, from antberry to zog brains.
Brains,
said Cuthbert, a zombie cupcake that lived in a little cage on the counter. Joe had created him accidentally one afternoon by sprinkling zombie powder over some cupcakes. Cuthbert's five little eyes blinked brightly at the mention of brains. They were his favourite food. Fuzzby fed him scrambled eggs and pretended they were brains, but Cuthbert didn't seem to notice and mostly sat happily in his cage. Joe saw that Barry had a mischievous look on his face.
I bet that you can't make a sandwich as good as Fuzzby, the cat said to Zuffby innocently.
Uh-oh, there'll be trouble, thought Joe. The two monster cousins eyed each other.
I bet I can, said Zuffby, holding Fuzzby's stare.
I bet you can't.
Bet I can.
Bet you can't.
I can. You can't. Can. Can't. Can. Can't.
I bet I can make the biggest, most spectacular mega monster sandwich ever seen since the great fish paste catastrophe at last year's Monster Fair, said Zuffby loudly.
The monsters in the diner gasped and dropped their cutlery in shock. What happened at the great fish paste catastrophe? Whispered Joe.
Boris Swamppot made a sandwich so big that even Mr. Jubbins couldn't finish it, said Fuzzby.
Mr. Jubbins was a blue jelly monster who often came into the diner. Mr. Jubbins's huge see-through tummy was legendary. It could take anything, and sometimes did. Fuzzby continued the tale.
He ate so much rancid fish paste, his insides began to bubble and blow up like a balloon, until soon he was bigger than a house. But he couldn't keep all that gas inside forever. Before long, he let out a fart so big and loud that it blew away half of the fair and set fire to the rest, as well as sending a shockwave that shattered windows in the nearest town. And he was followed around by hundreds of cats for days afterwards.
Us cats like a bit of fish, you know,
Barry pointed out helpfully, as Mr. Jubbins shifted uncomfortably in his chair.
Think you're up to the competition, Fuzzby,
said Zuffby, coolly examining his nails.
Of course,
said Fuzzby, slamming a fist on the countertop.
A Bixington never backs away from a challenge. Let the sandwich contest begin.
The customers all cheered and eagerly gathered round the two big monsters.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.